Hello. Nomad Sculpt Quick Shots Part 25. Let's sculpt quick pumpkin head for Halloween. Let's switch to the Nomad app. Let's create a new scene. That shows a wireframe. We can give it this sphere a little bit of more of subdivision. One time, okay, I think it's okay. We use the front view, and the first step is to adjust the symmetry settings, turn off the X plane, and give the Y radius a count of 11. I think it's okay. Then we use the crease tool. Crease tool settings are normal, fall off like this. And we can adjust the intensity. And sometimes it's useful to use a reference. Okay, go to the front view, symmetry is on, and we can make a few creases here. I think okay, that's enough. Only the basic steps. You can give this whole thing a lot of more detail if you like. Okay, let's use the drag function. You can leave the symmetry on and set on the left side the normal button that makes it perpendicular to the surface, the drag. You can adjust the size of the drag, and now you can bring this a little bit inside, and this part a little bit to look more like a pumpkin. Okay, you can turn now, okay, you can adjust it a little bit, make the size of the brush a little bit smaller. This step was not so fine. Okay, and you can turn the symmetry off and adjust it like this. Make it a little bit more natural. And you can use a crease function again and turn the symmetry on and add more creases if you like. That's detail working. Okay. I think it's fine. Now we use the trim function to trim off to trim out the face. But before we make in the top view a selection mask, turn the symmetry off and mask the backside of the pumpkin. And go to the front view. Now use the trim function in the trim settings, hole filling is off, and you can use the lasso tool to cut out the eyes. And the mouth. Now you can go to the selection mask and clear the mask. Wireframe off. In the top view, you can use the mask tool to mask the part. If you want to make a deckel to separate the top of the pumpkin, and go to the settings of the mask and change the shell thickness to 0. And now you can split it, shell, and split it. And you can bring it a little bit up to separate it from the pumpkin. And now you can use the selection mask, mask this part, and in the settings you can change the shell thickness to 1 and extract the shell like this. You can make a solo view and look at the parts. This part we don't need anymore, and turn the solo view off and change to the pumpkin itself. Use the selection mask again, turn the symmetry off, mask it, and the shell is, the thickness is 1, it's okay, and extract it. I think it's okay. Now you can go to the topology and change the voxel remeshing and remesh the mesh. Make a solo view. Check the mesh. You can delete it. Now you got the parts, the two parts of the pumpkin. You can here you can try to cut some things cleaner out. I go to the top view, selection mask, and we can use the trim function. And now in the trim function, check on hole filling, symmetry off, and look what happens. If you need a cleaner edges, you can adjust it here a little bit. Yes. You can smooth it with a smooth brush. To make some parts cleaner. That's detail working. Okay. Go to the selection mask and clear it. Okay. You can use the tube. Create a path. And radius you can adjust like this, and don't know the word for it, trunk or something. You can turn on the wireframe, look at it, and okay, we can validate it, and we subdivide it one time or two times. You can use the crease function, symmetry off, and crease it a few times. And you can give it a color. To make it a little bit like this. Okay. We can give also the pumpkin a color. Turn the wireframe off. This one and paint all. And the last thing is to add a light. Go to the shading, add a light, go in the top view, place it in the middle of the pumpkin head and go to the light settings, press on the light and make it a point light. You can adjust the light settings, intensity and so on. Now turn on the perspective view and the post-processing, ambient occlusion, and turn off the outlines. The reference we don't need anymore. And at this point, you can, yes, you can bring more details on it, crease and look, look what happens. Or you can you can give it a little bit of structure with the right brush. Intensity. Okay, I think it's fine. Okay, have fun with sculpting, ciao.